So hopefully what you learned from the previous example is that building a random test case generator doesn't have to be very difficult. But realistically, it's usually a little bit more involved than the one we just saw. And a key problem is generating inputs that are valid. Or another way to say that is generating inputs that are part of the input domain for the software under test. What I want to do here is look at the entire space of random inputs. And what I mean by entire space of random inputs is we haven't ruled anything out. So what we get is random ones and zeros. And so remember that we're constructing random inputs. We're going to be feeding those into some software under test, and we're looking for outputs in the range of the software under test. And let's say, for sake of argument, that we're testing a web browser. And so the question we have to ask ourselves is, how much of the space of totally random ones and zeros constitutes a valid input for a web browser? And let's say that we're testing the rendering engine part of the web browser. So we're testing what happens when data comes over the web to the web browser in response to an HTTP request. Now the web browser wants to render that. So we have totally random ones and zeros. And as you might expect, almost all arbitrary combinations of ones and zeros fail to create valid web pages. There's going to be some small subset of the set of random inputs that constitutes valid input to the web browser. And if we take one of these other inputs and hand it to the web browser, it's going to be mapped to a part of the output space that corresponds to malformed HTML. Now, one thing we might ask is, isn't that a good thing to test web browsers with completely invalid inputs to see if, for example, instead of returning a page error, it's easily possible that some subset of this space corresponds to browser crashes? So the answer is yes, we definitely do want to test our web browser with completely random inputs. But on the other hand, the amount of code in a web browser that serves to classify codes as renderable versus not renderable is some very tiny fraction of the total amount of code in the web browser. And if the fraction of valid HTML is very low, we're going to spend almost all of our time testing this very small part of the web browser. So what we probably want to do is take some tests from this broader set of completely random inputs, but take most of our tests from the set of valid web pages. So these are the ones which, when we select a random input in here, are going to, with some probability, end up exposing something like cross-site scripting bugs. Here I'm just going to ignore little details like the fact that we'd probably need to be generating JavaScript as well in order to make these kind of bugs happen. We're mostly trying to look at the abstract problem here.